हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी हैव टू स्टार्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ एक्ट फोर सीन वन द मर्चेंट ऑफ वेनिस। ओके नाउ सीन वन वेनिस। अ कोर्ट ऑफ जस्टिस एंटर द ड्यूक द मैग्निफिकोस एंटोनियो बसानियो ग्रेशियानो सेलेरियो एंड अदर्स। सो दिस सीन टेक्स प्लेस इन अ कोर्ट ऑफ जस्टिस वेनिस। Okay, very, very, very important. This you have to keep in mind that this is a trial scene and it takes place in a court of justice in Venice. And who all are present here in the court of justice? The Duke, the Magnificos, Antonio, Bassanio, Graciano, Salerio and others. Now, Duke says, what is Antonio here? Now, Duke is asking there in straight away that what is Antonio here? What means? Well, it is given other side. You can also look other side for the meanings. So, well, is Antonio here? So, Antonio says he was there in the court of justice. So, Antonio says, ready. So, please, your grace. So, what Antonio replied? That, yes, your grace, I am ready. Then, Duke said, I am sorry for thee. Thou art come to answer a stony adversary, an inhuman wretch, incapable of pity, void and empty from any dram of mercy. So what Duke says? That I am sorry for thee. So Duke says to whom? Duke says to Antonio that I am really sorry for thee, that I really feel sorry for you, that thou art come to answer, that is, you have come here to answer a stony adversary, an inhuman wretch, incapable of pity, void and empty from any dram of mercy. So meanings also you can see other side at first. So point number four, the stony is there. Stony means hard-hearted. And point number three, answer, that means defend yourself against. And adversary is given, that means opponent. And incapable, that means incapable. That during the Shakespeare time, there was little difference in English, and Shakespeare wrote as we use today, incapable. So instead of incapable, he used to write incapable. And then void, void means devoid of, that is nothing, empty, vacant. And then dram is given, point number six. Dram means smallest quantity. Okay, that is 1/8 of fluid ounce. Now here what Duke says to Antonio, that I am sorry for thee, thou art come to answer a stony adversary, an inhuman wretch. That means for whom he is saying, in whose against he is saying? He is saying against Shylock. Okay, so the way the kind of conversation Duke has with Antonio, that shows that Duke is in favor of Antonio. So he says that I'm really sorry for you, Antonio. Thou art come to answer, that you have to come here in the court of justice to answer a stony adversary, that is, you have come here to defend yourself against this hard-hearted and inhuman wretch. That is, inhuman wretch. Wretch means miserable. So he says that this inhuman, miserable way behavior that Shylock has been doing with you, so you have come here to defend yourself, to protect yourself against this hard-hearted man and inhuman wretch, incapable of pity. That is, this man who is incapable of showing any mercy, this man who is incapable of showing any pity, void and empty from any dram of mercy. That is, this person who is void and empty, that is, who is devoid of any kind of mercy, that is, not even a single, not even the smallest quantity of mercy also is in his heart. So you have come here to answer him, this man, such a man, such a Jew. So I really feel sorry for you, that you have come here to defend yourself against such a hard-hearted person. Then after this, what Antonio says, that I have heard your grace has taken great pains to qualify his rigorous course, but since he stands obdurate, and that no lawful means can carry me out of his envy's reach, I do oppose my patience to his fury and am armed to suffer with a quietness of spirit the very tyranny and rage of his. Now what Antonio says, that I have heard your grace has taken great pains to qualify his rigorous course. Now, meaning you can see other side at first. Point number 8, qualify is given, that means moderate. And then 9, rigorous course, that means strict court proceeding. And obdurate is given, that means adamant. That means, adamant means stubborn, ziddi. Okay, so here, Shylock says, I have heard your grace. So he says to whom? He is now giving reply to the Duke. That yes, I have heard your grace. That is, yes, I have heard Duke, your grace. That is, he is addressing Duke, your grace has taken great pains to qualify. That you have taken great pains for my sake. Okay, that you have taken great pains for my sake to qualify, that is to moderate. Moderate here we can say, that is to change his rigorous course, that is his strict court proceeding. That is the way as Shylock was here and is demanding for the penalty, a pound of flesh from my body. So I have heard enough about you, that how much you have sincerely tried to change this strict case proceeding. Okay, but since he stands obdurate, and then Antonio says, but since he stands, now he here refers for Shylock, that is as Shylock here, as he stands obdurate, that is he is adamant, that is as he is so stubborn on this, that he wants to have his penalty as per the legal bond. Okay, so he says, वो कहता है कि जैसे कि Shylock एक ये जिद पकड़ लिया है कि वो अपना decision change नहीं करेगा, and that no lawful means can carry me out of his envy's reach. And then Antonio says, and that no lawful means can carry me, कि मतलब कि कोई भी एक legally तरीका नहीं बचा है. Point number 2, you can see other side, lawful means, that means legal means of rescuing. Rescuing means saving. So he says that as there is no legal means of rescuing me out of his envy's reach. Okay, point number 11, you can see, that is away from his malice, that there is no lawful means is left which can now save me from his hands. Okay, then I do oppose my patience to his fury. Now what he says, that I do oppose my patience to his fury, that is I shall meet his anger with patience. You can see other side, point number 11 to 12 line meaning is given. So what Antonio says, that I shall meet his anger with patience, to suffer with a quietness of spirit the very tyranny and rage of his. Now what he says, that with a quietness of spirit, that I have prepared myself, okay, that I have prepared myself, that I will quietly give whatever he will ask for, that whatever he asks for, if he wants to cut a pound of flesh from my body, so let him cut. I have prepared myself and quietly I will give, and I am ready to face his anger. Okay, tyranny and rage is there, that means anger, that I am ready to face his anger quietly, that I have prepared my soul, I have prepared my spirit. Okay, then after this, what Duke replied, line number 15, Duke says, go one and call the Jew into the court. Now what Duke says? Duke says that one of you go and call the Jew Shylock. Okay, so one of you go and call the Jew into the court. That one, go one here is given. Other side, point number 15, that is somebody. Then Salario says that he is ready at the door. He comes, my lord. Now what Salario replied? He is ready at the door. That he is standing there at the road. Door. So he comes, my lord. That is, now here he comes. Enter Shylock. Now as Shylock entered, what Duke says, that make room and let him stand before our face. Shylock, the world thinks, and I think so too, that thou but leadest this fashion of thy malice to the last hour of act, and then 'tis thought thou wilt show thy mercy and remorse more strange than is thy strange apparent cruelty, and where thou now exact the penalty, which is a pound of this poor merchant's flesh, thou wilt not only lose the forfeiture, but also forgive the moiety of the principal, glancing an eye of pity on his losses that have of so late huddled on his back, in order to press a royal merchant down and pluck commiseration of his state from brassy bosoms and rough hearts of flint, from stubborn Turks and Tartars never trained to offices of tender courtesy. We all expect a gentle answer due. Okay, now here in this speech, what the Duke says to Shylock. Now see, Act 4, Scene 1. This act is very, very, very important, dear children, with the examination point of view. If you see the old question papers that have come, that is board exam question papers, then at least one question you will surely find from Act 4, trial scene. That is, no one can neglect this scene. It is very, very, very important. That is, if you focus on this scene, Act 4, then it is sure that you will be able to attempt at least one question of Merchant of Venice from this part. Okay, so all the conversation in this, whether the conversation of Shylock with the Duke or Duke with Antonio, or further whatever we will study will come. So all the points, all the extracts are important in this. So you need to take care very much of this scene. Understand it very, very, very nicely, each and every point, and you should also go through the meanings which are given on the other side. Okay, now what Duke says, make room and let him stand before our face. So Duke says that as Shylock entered into the court, so Duke said that make room, that is, make room means that give him some place to come and stand before us, and let him come and stand before our face. And then as Shylock came and stood in front of the Duke, so Duke continued saying, Shylock, the world thinks, and I think so too. So Duke said that Shylock, the world thinks. The world thinks means that everyone who ever heard about the case. Okay, that everyone who heard about the case, the world thinks, and I think so too. And I also have the same thought. I also thought the same. That thou but leadest this fashion of thy malice to the last hour of act. Now what he says, that is 19 to 20 number, you can see other side it is given, that thou but are that you only continue with your show of cruelty until the last moment. Okay, what Duke says, that is, everyone thought this, or everyone think this, that you only continue with your show of cruelty until the last moment. That is, in such a cruel way as you were behaving with Antonio. Okay, the bad behavior as you were having with Antonio. So we thought that you will continue with this